What's up, everybody? Welcome to today's video. In today's video, I'm going to teach you 100 advanced English phrases that are going to completely change your English forever. And the reason why is because all these phrases contain the most common words, verbs, and expressions in the English language, and they're all put into sentences in the most advanced grammatical tenses in the English language, such as the past perfect, present perfect, and even the conditional tense, which is the most advanced English grammar. Typically, for a student who tries to learn this the traditional way in university or in school or with a professor, it takes years. But in this video, you're going to learn all that stuff with just one simple exercise. First, I'm going to show you a phrase in English on the screen right here. And I'm going to give you a couple of seconds to just listen and think, what could this phrase mean? And then I'm going to show you the translation or the explanation in Spanish. Now, the only thing you need to do is sit back, relax, and enjoy, and just consume these phrases at your own pace. You don't need to talk, you don't need to imitate, you don't need to take notes. You just need to relax and just watch these phrases as they come by. Because what's gonna happen is that when you go through all these 100 phrases, you're going to start to see similarities, and your brain will make the connections. It will start to see the similarities and how these grammatical structures and words are linked together. So basically, you don't have to do anything but sit back, relax, and enjoy. Now, before we get started, it's important that you understand that, of course, you're not gonna learn one phrase by listening to it once. We need to repeat these phrases over and over again. Therefore, we're going to apply a little secret learning technique called spaced repetition to ensure that you don't forget what you learn in this video. And so what I want you to do is to follow this very simple structure. Today, I want you to watch this video 3 times. Yes, this very video, I want you to watch it 3 times. You just sit back, relax, and watch the video 3 times. Tomorrow, I want you to watch the same video again, this very video twice. So what you can do is you can click on the save button here below this video. There's a button that says save. You can click on that, and tomorrow when you log into YouTube, you're going to see this very video again. So I want you to watch it twice tomorrow. The day after that, I want you to watch it once. Then the next day, which is the 4th day, I want you to watch this very same video once again. And then on the 5th day, you don't watch it. And then on the 6th day, you watch it one last time. If you do this, I guarantee you're going to make massive improvements in your English, because you are repeating and internalizing these grammar structures into your brain, as well as the vocabulary, so that in the future, you're going to be able to recognize these words and these grammar structures, and also be able to produce them yourself more automatically, more effortlessly. This is a very similar way to how we actually learn languages ourselves as children. So let's get started. I hope you're ready. Just make sure to click save here down below in the video, and then we'll get started with the phrases immediately. Here we go. If I'd been hungry, I would have eaten something. If I'd been hungry, I would have eaten something.
Si yo hubiera estado con hambre, habría comido algo.
I've always been a very responsible person. I've always been a very responsible person.
Siempre he sido una persona muy responsable.
He had had a good job before joining our team this year. He had had a good job before joining our team this year.
Él había tenido un buen trabajo antes de unirse a nuestro equipo este año.
I have done everything I was asked to do. I have done everything I was asked to do.
He hecho todo lo que me pidieron hacer.
She wouldn't have done what she did if it hadn't been necessary. She wouldn't have done what she did if it hadn't been necessary.
Ella no hubiera hecho lo que hizo si no habría sido necesario.
I have been to almost 60 countries in my life. I have been to almost 60 countries in my life.
He estado en casi 60 países en mi vida.
The food was bad, but it wasn't a big deal because I had already gotten something to eat. The food was bad, but it wasn't a big deal because I had already gotten something to eat.
La comida era mala, pero no era gran problema porque ya había comido algo.
He has thought about all the opportunities he wasted. He has thought about all the opportunities he wasted.
Él ha pensado en todas las oportunidades que desperdició.
She has seen this film twice.
She has seen this film twice.
Ella ha visto esta película dos veces.
I've always wanted to study abroad. I've always wanted to study abroad.
Siempre he querido estudiar en el exterior.
You wouldn't have come here if I hadn't invited you.
You wouldn't have come here if I hadn't invited you.
No hubieses venido acá si no te hubiese invitado.
She had already found a job when I asked her to come work for me. She had already found a job when I asked her to come work for me.
Ella ya había encontrado un trabajo cuando le pedí que viniera a trabajar conmigo.
Today, I needed her help and she was very nice. Probably because she had asked me for help 2 days ago.
Today, I needed her help and she was very nice. Probably because she had asked me for help 2 days ago.
Hoy necesité su ayuda y era muy amable. Probablemente porque me había pedido ayuda hace 2 días.
I wouldn't have called you if I hadn't had this terrible problem.
I wouldn't have called you if I hadn't had this terrible problem.
No te habría llamado si no hubiera tenido este terrible problema.
My financial situation has become a big problem.
My financial situation has become a big problem.
Mi situación financiera se ha tornado un gran problema.
She had felt the earthquake. That was why she was scared.
She had felt the earthquake. That was why she was scared.
Ella había sentido el terremoto. Por eso, ella estaba asustada.
He had already left the party when we arrived, so we never met each other.
He had already left the party when we arrived, so we never met each other.
Él ya había salido de la fiesta cuando llegamos, entonces nunca nos conocimos.
We wouldn't have become such good doctors if we hadn't studied so hard.
We wouldn't have become such good doctors if we hadn't studied so hard.
No nos habríamos tornado tan buenos médicos si no hubiéramos estudiado tan duro.
I've always had a good posture.
I've always had a good posture.
Siempre he tenido una buena postura.
I was impressed she had kept our secret.
I was impressed she had kept our secret.
Estaba impresionado que ella había mantenido nuestro secreto.
I was very hurt because she had really meant what she said.
I was very hurt because she had really meant what she said.
Yo estaba muy herido porque ella realmente quiso decir lo que dijo.
We had given them a hand before they got married.
We had given them a hand before they got married.
Les habíamos echado una mano antes de que se casaran.
The restaurant was new. I had never been there before.
The restaurant was new. I had never been there before.
El restaurante era nuevo. Yo nunca había estado ahí antes.
She hadn't said what she wanted. That was why she was disappointed about what we gave her.
She hadn't said what she wanted. That was why she was disappointed about what we gave her.
Ella no había dicho lo que quería. Por eso, estaba decepcionada con lo que le dimos.
If I'd been cold,
I would have put something on. If I had been cold, I would have put something on.
Si hubiera tenido frío, me habría puesto algo.
They wouldn't have needed my help if they had had enough experience. They wouldn't have needed my help if they'd had enough experience.
Ellos no hubieran necesitado de mi ayuda si habrían tenido suficiente experiencia.
You've waited for her decision all year long.
You've waited for her decision all year long.
Has esperado de su decisión todo el año.
When I finished, everyone had left.
When I finished, everyone had left.
Cuando terminé, todos se habían ido.
If he waited patiently, he wouldn't get so nervous.
If he waited patiently, he wouldn't get so nervous.
Si él esperara pacientemente, no se pondría tan nervioso.
If she hadn't needed the money, she wouldn't have waited so long at the bank.
If she hadn't needed the money, she wouldn't have waited for so long at the bank.
Si ella no hubiera necesitado el dinero, no habría esperado por tanto tiempo en el banco.
My father served in the military ever since I was a little child.
My father served in the military ever since I was a little child.
Mi padre ha servido en el ejército desde que yo era niño.
When I asked the waitress for some wine, she had already served me and I hadn't noticed.
When I asked the waitress for some wine, she had already served me and I hadn't noticed.
Cuando le pedí un vino a la mesera, ya me había servido y yo no lo había notado.
If you served in the military, you would become a real man.
If you served in the military, you would become a real man.
Si sirvieras en el ejército, te volverías un gran hombre.
If I'd been luckier, I wouldn't have been sent to boarding school.
If I had been luckier, I wouldn't have been sent to boarding school.
Si hubiera tenido más suerte, no me habrían mandado a un internado.
I felt so sorry to inform him that his grandmother had passed away, because his wife had also passed away just recently.
I felt so sorry to inform him that his grandmother had passed away, because his wife had also passed away just recently.
Lamenté mucho decirle que su abuela había fallecido porque su mujer había fallecido también hace poco.
If you die before me, I'll be the saddest widow that ever existed.
If you die before me, I'll be the saddest widow that ever existed.
Si usted se muere antes que yo, yo seré la viuda más triste que jamás haya existido.
If he had had a healthier lifestyle, he wouldn't have died so young.
If he had had a healthier lifestyle, he wouldn't have died so young.
Si él hubiera tenido un estilo de vida más saludable, no habría muerto tan joven.
We wouldn't have gotten so strong if we hadn't trained so hard.
We wouldn't have gotten so strong if we hadn't trained so hard.
No fuéramos tan fuertes si no hubiéramos entrenado tan duro.
Since we got married, I've never expected anything romantic from him.
Since we got married, I've never expected anything romantic from him.
Desde que nos casamos, nunca he esperado nada romántico de él.
His parents had never expected anything from him until now that he announced he was going to be a dad.
His parents had never expected anything from him until now that he announced he was going to be a dad.
Sus padres nunca habían esperado nada de él hasta ahora que anunció que iba a ser papá. If I expected something different from you, I would call myself a lunatic. If I expected something different from you, I would call myself a lunatic. Si yo esperara algo diferente de ti, me llamaría lunático. If he hadn't always been this great of a son, his parents wouldn't have expected him to become so successful. If he hadn't always been this great of a son, his parents wouldn't have expected him to become so successful.
Si no fuera siempre un hijo tan bueno, sus padres nunca hubieran esperado que tuviera tanto éxito.
That was new. I'd never done that before. That was new. I had never done that before.
Eso era nuevo. Nunca había hecho eso antes.
He built a house in the town he and his parents had lived during their whole lives. He built a house in the town he and his parents had lived during their whole lives.
Él construyó una casa en la ciudad en la que él y sus papás habían vivido toda su vida.
If she built a house here, I would try to find a piece of land and build mine too. If she built a house here, I would try to find a piece of land and build mine too.
Si ella construyera una casa acá, yo trataría de encontrar un lote y construir la mía también.
If we hadn't found a job in this area of town, we wouldn't have moved here. If we hadn't found a job in this area of town, we wouldn't have moved here.
Si no hubiéramos encontrado trabajo en esta zona de la ciudad, nunca nos habríamos mudado aquí.
He stayed in my house for a couple of days this week. He stayed in my house for a couple of days this week.
Él se ha quedado un par de días en mi casa esta semana.
The resort was fantastic. My wife had stayed there before and convinced me we should come together. The resort was fantastic. My wife had stayed there before and convinced me we should come together.
El resort estuvo fantástico. Mi esposa se había quedado ahí antes y me convenció que fuéramos ahí juntos.
If she stays here for one more day, I'll have to find another place to live. If she stays here one more day, I'll have to find another place to live.
Si ella se queda acá un día más, yo tendré que buscar otro lugar para vivir.
If we hadn't enjoyed our company so much, we wouldn't have stayed here for so long. If we hadn't enjoyed your company so much, we wouldn't have stayed here for so long.
Si no hubiéramos disfrutado tanto de su compañía, nunca nos habríamos quedado aquí por tanto tiempo.
Two tourists have died on the reef this year. It's very dangerous. Two tourists have died on the reef this year. It's very dangerous.
Dos turistas han muerto este año en este arrecife. Es muy peligroso.
I find it hard to make ends meet on such a low salary. I find it hard to make ends meet on such a low salary.
Encuentro difícil tener suficiente dinero con un salario tan bajo.
We've run out of time. Let's bounce. We've run out of time. Let's bounce.
Se nos acabó el tiempo. Vámonos.
I can't be bothered to do my homework this evening. I can't be bothered to do my homework this evening.
No quiero hacer mi tarea esta noche.
It is bound to happen again if you don't change your habits. It is bound to happen again if you don't change your habits.
Es muy probable que vuelva a suceder si no cambias tus hábitos.
At the time, I still hadn't found out about his mental problems. At the time, I still hadn't found out about his mental problems.
En ese momento, todavía no me había enterado de sus problemas mentales.
Ever since you told me the news, I can't think about anything else. Ever since you told me the news, I can't think of anything else.
Desde que me contaste la noticia, no puedo pensar en algo más.
I know you'll benefit from watching this video for a long time to come. I know you'll benefit from watching this video for a long time to come.
Sé que ver este video te beneficiará por mucho tiempo.
When I have kids, I'd love to live in the outskirts of the city. When I have kids, I'd love to live in the outskirts of the city.
Cuando tenga hijos, me encantaría vivir en las afueras de la ciudad.
Although they are divorced, they're still in good terms.
Although they are divorced, they are still on good terms.
Aunque están divorciados, todavía se llevan bien.
Bear in mind, the deadline is in a fortnight.
Bear in mind, the deadline is in a fortnight.
Tenga en cuenta que la fecha límite es dentro de 15 días.
Brace yourself. Winter is coming. Brace yourself. Winter is coming.
Prepárate. El invierno está llegando.
For some people, this would mean the end of the relationship. For others, it wouldn't. For some people, this would mean the end of the relationship. For others, it wouldn't.
Para algunas personas, esto sería el final de la relación. Para otras, no.
Pull yourself together. It's only a tiny insect. Pull yourself together. It's only a tiny insect.
Tranquilízate. Es solo un pequeño insecto.
I reckon that cryptocurrency will stand the test of time. I reckon that cryptocurrency will stand the test of time.
Creo que la criptomoneda mostrará su valor por un largo tiempo.
On average, kids in Sweden leave their parents' house at the age of 18. On average, kids in Sweden leave their parents' house at the age of 18.
En promedio, los niños suecos se van de la casa de sus papás a los 18 años.
All in all, the meeting went as had been planned.
All in all, the meeting went as had been planned.
En general, la cita se desarrolló según lo planeado.
As a result, we ran late and missed the first act.
As a result, we ran late and missed the first act.
Como resultado, llegamos tarde y nos perdimos el primer acto.
I prefer to just go with the flow instead of trying to control everything.
I prefer to just go with the flow instead of trying to control everything.
Prefiero seguir la corriente en lugar de tratar de controlarlo todo.
Instead of complaining about it, maybe you should look for a solution.
Instead of complaining about it, maybe you should look for a solution.
En lugar de quejarte, quizás debes buscar una solución.
She had already gotten fired when I asked her how work was going.
She had already gotten fired when I asked her how work was going.
Ya la habían despedido cuando le pregunté cómo estuvo el trabajo.
I was gonna go out, but I've changed my mind now.
I was gonna go out, but I've changed my mind now.
Iba a salir, pero ahora he cambiado de opinión.
As well as his lack of punctuality, he also reeks of alcohol.
As well as his lack of punctuality, he also reeks of alcohol.
Además de su falta de puntualidad, también huele demasiado alcohol.
Provided he arrives on time, I don't mind what he does.
Provided he arrives on time, I don't mind what he does.
Siempre que llegue a tiempo, no me importa lo que haga.
Is it worth traveling all over Australia?
Is it worth traveling all over Australia?
Vale la pena viajar por toda Australia.
Give me a call as soon as you arrive.
Give me a call as soon as you arrive.
Llámame cuando llegues.
By the time the bus left, I was already fast asleep. By the time the bus left, I was already fast asleep.
Cuando el autobús se fue, ya estaba profundamente dormido.
If he hadn't looked so on point today, I don't think he would have won. If he hadn't looked so on point today, I don't think he would have won.
Si no se hubiera visto tan acertado hoy, no creo que habría ganado.
It took ages to learn English before Cali came to the rescue. It took ages to learn English before Cali came to the rescue.
Tomó años aprender inglés hasta que Cali viniera a rescatarnos.
I was taken by surprise by her initial reaction. I was taken by surprise by her initial reaction.
Su reacción inicial me sorprendió.
I visit my family in Sweden from time to time. I visit my family in Sweden from time to time.
Visito a mi familia en Suecia de vez en cuando.
It's only a matter of time before you find a girlfriend. It's only a matter of time before you find a girlfriend.
Es solo cuestión de tiempo hasta que encuentres una novia.
I did an internship during which I made some pretty useful contacts. I did an internship during which I made some pretty useful contacts.
Hice un internado en el cual hice algunos contactos útiles.
We would have organized a trip if we hadn't undergone huge internal changes in the company at the moment. We would have organized a trip if you hadn't undergone huge internal changes at the moment in the company.
Habríamos organizado un viaje si no hubiéramos pasado por grandes cambios internos en la empresa en este momento.
Part of running a company is leading the way by example. Part of running a company is leading the way by example.
Parte de la gestión de una empresa es liderar con el ejemplo.
Electric cars have been in great demand for a while now. Electric cars have been in great demand for a while now.
Los coches eléctricos han tenido una gran demanda desde hace un tiempo.
I'm so sorry, I didn't do it on purpose. I'm so sorry, I didn't do it on purpose.
Lo siento mucho. No lo hice a propósito.
I broke your vase by accident. Please forgive me. I broke your vase by accident. Please forgive me.
Rompí tu jarrón por accidente. Por favor, perdóname.
I would have been willing to try again if you'd given me the chance. I would have been willing to try again if you'd given me the chance.
Habría estado dispuesto a intentarlo nuevamente si me hubieras dado la oportunidad.
I was praised for being the best student in class. I was praised for being the best student in class.
Me elogiaron por ser el mejor alumno de la clase.
I get a little worried about my studies every now and then.
I get a little worried about my studies every now and then. Me preocupo un poco por mis estudios de vez en cuando.
I was just about to say that. You stole the words out of my mouth. I was just about to say that. You stole the words out of my mouth.
Estaba a punto de decir eso. Me robaste las palabras de la boca.
In this day and age, the job market is extremely competitive. In this day and age, the job market is extremely competitive.
Hoy en día, el mercado laboral es extremadamente competitivo.
Sooner or later, you had to tell him the truth. Sooner or later, you had to tell him the truth.
Tarde o temprano, tenías que decirle la verdad.
It seems like ages ago since we last spoke. It seems like ages ago since we last spoke.
Parece que fue hace mucho tiempo desde la última vez que hablamos.
We had arrived home safe and sound at 8 p.m. when the fire alarm went off. We had arrived home safe and sound at 8 p.m. when the fire alarm went off.
Llegamos a la casa sanos y salvos a las 8 p.m. cuando sonó la alarma de incendio.
I'm reluctant to take up a new hobby. I'm reluctant to take up a new hobby. Soy reacio a asumir un nuevo pasatiempo. I wouldn't have hurt myself if the knife hadn't slipped out of my hand. I wouldn't have hurt myself if the knife hadn't slipped out of my hand. No me habría hecho daño si el cuchillo no se me hubiera escapado de la mano. She had already made up her mind when I asked her out. She had already made up her mind when I asked her out. Ella ya había tomado una decisión cuando la invité a salir. In a nutshell, this video is bloody brilliant. In a nutshell, this video is bloody brilliant. En pocas palabras, este video es increíblemente brillante. Well done, you have watched all the 100 phrases now. Remember your homework, you have to watch this video 2 more times today. So, rewind and watch this video again now 2 times. And then, tomorrow, remember to follow the schedule. Tomorrow, you're gonna watch the same video 2 times. So right now, here below, you can click on the button that says save. And then tomorrow when you log into YouTube, you're going to see the video there and you can just resume watching it. Or you can also click like on the video and then you're able to see your liked videos and just can go back. And also if you do like the video and subscribe, this video will be sent to more people who need help with their English. And you're supporting me in my mission to help more Latinos around the world develop their English and improve the lives of themselves and their families. Quick note, when you're doing this exercise, feel free to pick up your phone and record yourself a selfie video and upload to Instagram and tag me and I will repost you on my Instagram. And of course as well, after the exercise, when you're done, after the 6 days, come back here please and let me know in the comments below what you thought about this exercise. It is so important that you follow the schedule if you really, really want to elevate your English. Because tomorrow, you are going to have forgotten these phrases unless you follow this structure and this schedule. Trust me, I've done this for many years now. I know what I'm doing. So follow this schedule and you'll see tremendous, tremendous growth in your English. I really hope you liked the video. Please like and subscribe. Help support my vision of getting English out there in an easy and accessible way to Latinos all over the world so that you can improve your lives and the lives of your families. Thank you so much. I'll see you again very soon.